appreciation for Ged Kearney coming along today. And you know, it was a very important presentation, and one we don't really pick up on the media that much. The fact that I didn't know that it is as much as 10% of the workforce that is a temporary visa, and that's an extraordinary distribution. You can imagine easily how much of that workforce is exploited unfairly and illegal. And I think that's a real issue. And also we touched on the right to work, which is one of those fundamental human rights that is denied to asylum seekers and others in the community. Not only is that a denial of fundamental human rights, but it also is an ultimate cost for the community, because the cost of keeping people out of work is so much higher than allowing them to work and contribute. And so, I think it was a very important presentation today. I'd like to call on Affinity to present the
It's from the Acru shop, apparently. It's from the in appreciation of your contribution to the Affinity Lecture Series. I'm thinking about that. It's a beautiful
thing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's lovely. Thank you.
You're right. Thank you.
Thanks very much. It's beautiful. Thank you very much.
And I'd just like to say that Affinity, which has organised today's event, relies on local businesses and individuals to fund its many programs and events. The sponsors deserve our most sincere thanks, because without their support, it would not be easy for Affinity to bring us all together today. Today's sponsor is, I thought there was a slide here, no, but it's this one, Tropical Transport. I think if I can call on you to present a certificate of appreciation to Mr. Ulrich Kulku, the owner of Tropics Transport.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much, my uncle Stephen. The gratitude, my distinguished guests, esteemed friends, ladies and gentlemen, and my newly extended families, uncles, aunties, cousins, and friends. As the executive director of Affinity Tech Culture Foundation, I would like to thank you all for taking time out of your busy schedules to come out on the event today. We are very lucky to have many respectable guests amongst us. Our aim at Affinity is to provide and facilitate an open forum where we can all get together from diverse backgrounds and interests to discuss topics and issues common to us all. This afternoon's topic touches us all in some way, because we need to discuss the future of Australia today. We organize these and similar events in order to build understanding and cooperation through interaction with all sectors of society. Rather than a clash of civilization, Affinity strongly supports dialogue of civilization, which is essential in 21st century. This gives us an opportunity to voice, share, and raise our concern and awareness of matters close to our hearts in the right context and with the right people. I hope all these aims have been and will continue to be achieved. It was very refreshing to hear that take on the collective behind meetings and how this collectivity can positively impact Australian society. I strongly believe that when cross sections of society work together, we can seize the opportunity to see the light ahead, and I hope that Affinity can play a role in facilitating that discussion. We as Affinity remain dedicated to what are we doing here today, that is living in awareness of the importance of harmony, the need for building bridges and promoting friendship and respect within our society, and aim to do so by working to organize events such as today's program. We have to work like Michel Payne, and who after 155 years, multiple injuries and the male dominated nature of the sport, proceeded to become the first female jockey to win the Melbourne Cup. And for now, that's why I just want that. We greatly appreciate the speakers who accepted our request to come here and share the same passion and their insights on our common concern. What I see is that they support dialogue and friendship, and that is one of their great contributions to contemporary Australian society. We need to have these discussions today so that we are prepared for tomorrow. I would like to thank Ged Kearney, President of Australian Council of Trade Unions, for coming here to share her insight and expertise on this topic, which is a very significant one for all Australians. Thank you, Ged. And you came from Melbourne. Thank you so much. And I would also like to thank our sponsor, Mr. Lupulukchi. He is my cousin, owner of the Chocolate Transport. Thank you, Mr. Lupulukchi. Also, thank you, my uncle Stephen Blanks of New South Wales Council for Civil Liberties, for your fantastic work facilitating the program today. He is, of course, a remarkable person and valuable individual to our society. Thank you. I would like to shove back Gerardine a small gift. And please accept this on behalf of the community as a small token of our appreciation. To present the gift, I would like to call my cousin, Mr. Ged Kearney.
In appreciation of your contribution to the Affinity Radio Series, this is November 2015. Free man. Thank you.
And lastly, I haven't forgotten our esteemed advisory board member, Professor Emeritus, my uncle Alan Knight. And if I can be called up in Ged Kearney to present a small gift to Professor Emeritus Alan Knight, is a Turkish delight from my uncle's shop. Thank you so much. Before finishing the program, I would like to announce and invite you to some of Affinity's upcoming events. To finish off the year, our final lecture for 2015 will be presented by Professor Jonas Rosito, International Affairs and Islamic Studies, Georgetown University, Washington, D.C. We will also have Professor Greg Barton from Deakin University as a response speaker. So the program is the 2nd of December. Here, lunchtime. If you are available, please let me know. I would like to mention two fresh projects of Affinity's launched this year, the Barbecue and Breakfast Initiative. If you and your family are interested in joining one of the weekend programs, please let me know and I will arrange a barbecue on a Saturday or a breakfast on a Sunday with a host Muslim family according to your availability. Yeah. Next one, please. Yes, we welcome all of you to these programs with your partners, families, friends, colleagues, and your pets. You can bring your pets as well. You can find more details about these and other events on our website. A big thank you to you all for attending our program this afternoon. I hope to see you soon. Thank you so much.